हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द सेशन. ओके, एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट विद रीकैप. And we are talking about VPC, right? VPC. And VPCs are virtual private clouds. And when you create VPC, all you do is give a name, CIDR block. What is this CIDR block? Instead of calling CIDR block, CIDR range. You'll give CIDR range, and within that CIDR range, instances and other services within your VPC will get IP address. And when you create VPC, you'll assign name, of course, name, a region also, availability zone, and then yeah, as in CIDR range. And then we have created, the next thing you do is attach internet gateway, create and attach internet gateway. That means your VPC now it becomes a VPC, a network which can communicate on internet. Internet gateway is a software that allows your services within your VPC to communicate on the internet. So we have attached internet gateway. And then we have created subnets. Subnets are nothing but you are creating your network into parts, dividing it into parts. Why? Because you will have a facility of maintaining these subnets, suppose some instances which you wish to expose on the internet, you can keep on public subnet. Some instances which you wish, you can keep it on private subnet. And also, suppose if your organization is on AWS, you can create different subnets and also different VPCs. We'll come to that later. Different subnets, say some EC2 instances in particular subnet have development servers, not production, of course. They are still under the developing process, and you can use one subnet for testing process, right? So you can segregate, divide your VPC into subnetworks, and short form is subnets. And here you divide your subnets, and again here you have to look into the CIDR range. Right, so there is something called as subnet mask, or the first two of the first two octets will be standard. It has to be same as like VPC, and you can create subnets by changing the third octet and also the range. And we have talked about different ranges, slash 20, slash 16 means 65,000 IP addresses. Suppose if you, for your VPC, if you have given slash 16, always your subnet range has to be lower. And if higher is the number, lower will be the range. And we talked about it, dividing subnets. And then route tables. By default, you will have one route table attached with your VPC. When you create VPC, one route table will be default created, and that route table is called as main route table. And in this main route table, there will be a default rule, and that default rule is it routes traffic. Routes traffic within the VPC. So if your VPC routes within VPC, right? VPC CIDR range will be there. Suppose you want your subnet or the EC2 instances within the VPC to be public one. That means communication on the internet. Then not only attaching the internet gateway, you should also edit the route table. And you have to add internet rule. Let's call it as internet rule. One is default rule and another one is internet rule. Route on, or say route to internet. We know what internet 0.0.0.0/0 using internet gateway, and internet gateway is represented with the extension -igw. We also talked about it. Now your VPC with this change will have a route table, and also it has an internet gateway. Now if you launch any EC2 instance within the subnet, then automatically it will be, when you create a subnet, if you don't assign any route table explicitly to your subnet, that means it uses main route table. And you can go launch EC2 instances, and you can assign public IP. Suppose if you want to maintain some instances private within the same VPC, which has internet access, but you can divide a subnetwork, and you can create one more route table, right? And you can make it as private for private instances. So first you have to create a private subnet. Create a subnet and then create route table. And without internet route. Attach route table or add subnet, which is private, of course, add private subnet. two route table. And then launch your public and private instance. Public instance we have launched in public subnet. Private instance should be launched in private subnet. And we have discussed up to this so far, and we have also talked about DHCP options set. And then egress only gateways. Do try with egress only gateways also. The same procedure, what we have done, we have created a VPC and then attached internet gateway. Suppose you want control, you don't want traffic to visit, come into your network, but only go out, then instead of internet gateway, we will attach egress only internet gateway. Egress means egress traffic, traffic going outside, ingress traffic coming inside. Right, these are the things we have discussed, and today we will talk about NAT gateways. And just give me a minute, guys. Okay, and going to AWS console, and we are here. Yes, we know VPC with internet gateway, and your route table should have a rule, say, to allow traffic to the outside internet using internet gateway. That means your EC2 instances can communicate outside internet, and we know that. However, you can also create one more route table and add a private subnet, and this route table is not attached to your internet gateway. So that's why, so these instances are private instances, they don't have a public IP also. So in scenario one, suppose my application server is there in public subnet, and my backend server, database server, is there on the private subnet. And I know that these two instances can communicate each other within the VPC using private IP address. And we know that. But what if database server need updates, security patches, and other maintenance that has to be done? And for this, it has to install and configure with the assistance of internet. Then this server, backend server or database server, it needs to connect to internet. But this server is a part of private subnet. And also this server don't have an public IP. Instead of that, so if anything, any device want to connect internet, means it should get a public IP first, and also then a route table should have a rule to route the traffic to the internet, and we know that. So what here we will do is we will give NAT gateway. NAT stands for network address translation, and this NAT gateway resolves two things for this instance. So now this instance need to connect to internet, but it has two constraints. One is no public IP. Two is route table is not updated with internet rule. So let us launch a NAT gateway. NAT gateway resolves these two. NAT gateway will act as a public IP for this a backend server, which is a private one. So we'll create NAT gateway. NAT gateway will have one public IP and other two elastic IP. Why? Because every time we don't want our NAT gateway IP address to be changing one. So now public IP has been resolved by connecting to NAT gateway. This server can use public IP of your NAT gateway. Second thing, route table. Now your server communicates with the internet using NAT gateway. And where is NAT gateway? In the public subnet. Public subnet route table has internet route. So with the help of this NAT gateway, this backend server can communicate with the outside internet. Clear, guys? So let us launch one NAT gateway. First, we will go and see our EC2s. Two instances are there, public and private. Now I want private instance to connect to internet with the help of NAT gateway. Let us go back to VPC. And create a NAT gateway. So before creating a NAT gateway, we'll go to EC2 and connect to EC2 first. And first we will look into the security group. So this security group of public instance. So there is SSH and HTTP rule. And there is SSH rule, so I can connect to this instance by SSH into it. We know we can use PuTTY on Windows and on Mac terminal. Mac and Linux users can use terminal directly. I'll go to CD downloads and connect to my public instance. Right, this is my public IP, and I can SSH using key pair and public IP. Let us connect first. And then using this command, I can connect, right? If you're using PuTTY, you will give this as host address. And then you'll get that SSH private key, right, which you have converted .ppk from .pem. So you'll submit that. But host name is public. Okay, we have connected using public IP. But what about this private instance? How you can access this? Do I have any auto scaling group? No. Then let us delete this. Okay, public instance, private instance. See now how I can connect to this. So this private address is valid only on AWS VPC. And for SSH also we need public IP. And when you are connecting to any instance through SSH means SSH or PuTTY, what actually you're doing through internet using SSH protocol you are connecting. But how we connect with this instance, guys? Any ideas? This instance, look into it, no public IP. And I cannot connect through private IP. So private IP is valid within the local network. That means within the VPC which you have created. See, connect. So here it's private IP. Connect your instance using private IP, it's saying, but let's try. It won't work. So here we have used public IP. This is private IP. It won't work. It is not valid on the public internet. So let us close this. So now I have this instance. This instance is part of the VPC, right? And I know that two instances, when they are part of the same VPC, they can communicate with each other, right? See, this is my public server. This is private server. Private server has no IP address. And that's why we cannot SSH into it from our laptop using public internet. But I know that I can SSH from this device into this device, right? Because they are part of same VPC. Yes, now in the same VPC, private IP address is a valid one. Clear, guys? Any doubts? So now we are going to SSH from this public instance into private instance. And to SSH, what we need? So where it is here. Private key. So private key has to be there, right? To connect. So let us copy the private key. I'll log in as root user first. VI my key pair name demoec2.pem. I'll create the same file here, demoec2.pem. Escape I will take me to insert mode. Now I'll go and find this demo EC2. Control all, copy. I think you can directly copy and paste also using copy command. But anyway, copy this. Now go here. What I have done, I want this key file to connect to the instance. And I also know that I can SSH from my public instance to private instance because they both are part of VPC. And using private address, we can connect to private instance, but we need key, private key. So I am copying that private key from my laptop into the public instance. Paste, right? Escape again. WQ exclamatory mark. I have my key now. On this instance, demo ec2.pem is there, and using this I can connect to my private, right? And then as I said, Linux users and Mac users can SSH using terminal, and this our public instance is Amazon Linux 2AMI. From terminal itself we can SSH into other Linux instances. So let's go. Guys, are you getting this? Any doubts? Clear everything? Clear? Okay, and others? Lakshmi clear, Ipsita clear, okay. Now let us copy this. So we have to run this command to ensure your key is not publicly viewable. We are ensuring we are changing the permissions of demo ec2.pem. We are making that as a private one. What does this thing do, this command? Chmod. Chmod is the command used to change the permissions. Since this is a password key, a password kind of a key, file, .pem file, we are editing the permissions. Then only your Linux operating system allows, consider it as a private key, secret key. We are making it as not publicly viewable one. As a regular user, only root user can open this and view it. Regular users cannot open this .pem file. Why? Because we are editing the permission. Chmod 400 means only root users can open it. And also, we are not allowing regular users to make changes to it. So we are changing the permissions. This is done. Then only this can be considered as a secret key. After this, connect to your instance, right? Using this command. What this command says, we are using SSH protocol, and using this a key connecting to EC2 user at this IP address, and this is private IP address. Yes. See, now I have connected to my private instance. And this is private instance. And it don't have IP address as well as subnet where this EC2 is there. Don't have this internet route. So let me say pingoogle.com. I'll use sudo. Right, it says name or service unknown. Let us exit from here. So connection closed. I am back to my public instance. See, public instance. This is my private instance. Now I am in public instance. So it's working. This pin command is used to network, right? We are just sending some traffic to google.com. And we are getting this response back. Okay. stopped it. Let us and this is not working in private instance. Why? Because we know it cannot connect to internet. Let us go back and connect to our private instance. Right now I am at my private instance. Clear will clear the screen and take you to top again. Okay, and now let us go and set up NAT. VPC. NAT gateways. Create NAT gateway. This will say NAT for private subnet or private, let's say private subnet. I think it will not allow spaces, so NAT for private subnet. Network address translation for our private subnet. And which subnet? See here, this is NAT for private subnet. That means it should reside in the subnet which has a public route or internet route. That means public instance. So I have public, private. Let us choose public subnet. Remember, we are using NAT for two things. One is for resolving, it provides a public IP for the private instances. And also, it should be launched in a subnet where internet route has to be there. Internet route is there in my public subnet route table. So I have chosen public subnet here. And connectivity type, yes, public. We want a public NAT gateway. It asks to allocate elastic IP. Allocate elastic IP. Done. We have allocated an elastic IP. That's it. Two things. Once again, subnet, you have to choose the public subnet and IP address. And we don't want this IP address to be a changing one, public IP address again. That's why we have allocated an elastic IP. Create NAT gateway. And NAT gateways are not free tier eligible. So after completing your lab, immediately delete your NAT gateway. Keeping NAT gateway even for one day, you might get bill for that. State is pending. And this is NAT gateway's private IP address in network interface. We need network interface, right? When you are launching EC2 instances, public EC2 instances, a network interface used to be there. But here it's a NAT gateway. NAT gateway also allows to connect to internet. That means it needs an internet network interface, an elastic network interface. This is, and it is the part of VPC, my VPC. And I'm launching in public subnet. Other monitoring metrics. available now. Yes, now I have NAT gateway. I have public instance, private instance. I have also two subnets and two route tables. And I know that route table is very important. And using this route table only, routes will possible. Suppose devices, EC2 instances, if they want to send or receive within the network or outside the network, there has to be route in the route table. Let us go here and check public route table once. So EC2 instance in this public subnet can communicate locally because we have local route in the route table, and also EC2 instances within the public subnet where this route table is there can also communicate on the internet because internet route is there. Let's go back and check private instance. That is a private subnets route table. This is private subnets route table. And it has only local route, no public route. But here, what we are trying to do, we are trying to set up a NAT gateway. And using that NAT gateway, EC2 instances within this private subnet will be able to connect to outside internet. We have created NAT gateway, but no route. Route has to be there. So let us edit route. Add route to internet using NAT gateway. Now my private subnet has a route table with a rule saying that allow traffic to outside internet, allow out as well as in using NAT gateway. Clear, guys? So what we have done, we have created NAT gateway and also added a route in the route table of private subnets route table. Now let us come back and check. Let us connect once again. Come here, go to EC2 and connect to private instance. Private instance, connect. First, we have to make this key pair not publicly viewable one. So here now this is a private IP of our private EC2 instance. We have connected to this instance. See 190.168.90.62. Let's go and check. Right, this is our private instance. Private instance, right? Now I'll say pin google.com. Still I'm getting the same thing. Name or service not known. Let's go to EC2. Private instance, security. There is no HTTP rule. That's why we are getting this. There has to be HTTP rule. Let us add HTTP rule in our private instance. Edit. Oh, yeah, HTTP is there. Right. HTTP, it's called as TCP, custom TCP rule. Then it has to work. Okay, go here and check once again. Login as root user and test. Name or service not found. And then how we can check? Let's use ICMP. ICMP means network protocol. pin google.com. We tried this, it's not working. Right, we have added this ICMP rule also. Also, let's go to VPC and check route table once. Route table, private route table. Yes, we have added this rule and then. Okay, let's try now. Don't know why it's not working. And actually, you can connect to internet. We have configured everything, but to test, I'm not able to do this. Let's send any HTTP request. Pin in uppercase? No, it has to be lower only. No, lower only. Just give me a minute, guys. Okay, let's try to download anything from GitHub. GitHub. So there is some GitHub here. So let us copy this. Wget is the command. Sorry. Wget is the command used to download anything from the internet. Wget hyphen c. Okay, failed name or service not known. Same thing. Let us restart once. Let us try P in capital also. Okay. Let us have a look in NAT gateway. NAT gateway, we have connected to public. And this is Elastic IP we got. Okay, go to EC2. We will reboot it once. Yes, reboot. Successfully rebooted. Okay. Terminal. Ping google.com. Yeah, now it's working. So to apply those changes, maybe reboot is required. Now you can see I'm here. No, this is my public connection is closed. Sorry. So let us connect. Connected. Why is this is not working? Wget is also not working. Let's use HTTP instead of HTTPS. Unable to resolve the host address. Private instance, and we have attached NAT. Private instance, and then ESR private instance uses this route table. And coming to here, routes, yes, we have added NAT gateway. This is private instance, and yeah, I got it. See, this is private instance, but it don't have public IP, but it's part of a private subnet only. But my private subnet range is 192.168.80. 80 has to be there, and then my, this is private subnet, and let us have a look into public. Public is 96. Let's go and launch new EC2. It is 90.62 something. I don't know what's happening with this. This is the first time I'm facing these VPC issues. So I have launched this in private instance. Private instance CIDR range is 192.168 and the third octet is 80. But here I can see IPv4 address has .90. So let us go and launch a new instance. So terminate this instance. And a public instance has also 105. But we have given CIDR range of 96 to our public IP. Okay, let's launch one EC2 instance and check. my VPC, and we want private subnet. We don't want IP address, private subnet, next. Security group, let us add HTTP rule. Launch instance, view instance, what is this new one? Same EC2 instance. So let us go here. Yeah, now it is using 81. Let us try here. Private subnet. This is our private subnet, and to connect to it, connect. I'll copy this. Go here to my terminal. Yes. Yes. Again, we are getting the same error. So when I say wget command, it tries to download index.html from google.com. Let's see. Okay, I'll let you know what is the issue, guys. So the procedure is same, but here we are unable to connect. It's saying service not known. Whether we have to install anything. It used to work previously. This is the thing. Only thing is NAT gateway has to be in the route table. Then you can connect to internet from your EC2 instances. Okay, we will try to resolve this tomorrow. Okay, and also try with your accounts and let me know, is it working for you or not? Okay, then see you tomorrow. Yep, bye.